Welcome back to my starting my business series. I believe it's week 5 and it's around 8 a.m. Friday morning. Right now I'm driving down south, it's definitely not southern Jersey, but I'm meeting up with the owner of the entertainment company. It's like a 45 minute drive. I got me a large iced coffee. I use the Dunkin' app so much that I had a reward today, so I got that for free. And it's officially Kendrick season, baby. His album came out. Actually, I think it came out last night for some reason, but since it's a long drive, I'm just gonna be blasting the new Kendrick album on the way there. It's like song number one on his album. Well, actually song two after the intro, and I already like this more than How to Pimp a Butterfly. So you're getting pretty good at this, huh? The drone?
Yeah, I'm gonna show you a video later.
The guy needs to do it. I didn't bother me that much there.
Well, I thought it was him at first.
Yeah.
So we just got done with that. And basically we went around to 3 houses today. We had the drone up because the real estate agent who my client works with hires him to take aerial footage, mostly photos above the houses, right? So we had 3 houses to hit today. But the guy's name is Tim, who runs the entertainment and the video and stuff kind of footage company. And he does awesome work, like takes awesome videos, and he's able to do this for, it's not just for real estate, it's for any industry, anything like that. And I asked him to send me over a piece of his work so I can put it on here. And this is the house that I was talking about that he shot down in Florida that was like $20 million. So I'm gonna show you a little teaser vid right here, 30, 60 seconds, boom. As you can see, he does really high quality work, like awesome kind of stuff. And this is for anyone out there. You don't even have to have your own business. If you're looking for someone to take videos of anything, whether it's a party, wedding, grand opening for a business, you want to market a business, you want to do real estate, anything like that, he can do video for. That's really, really, really awesome shit. So if you want his contact info, hit me on through email, which is linked below. And I'll link up you guys together. So that was pretty cool, because he's really good with the drone, he's really good with editing and all that kind of stuff, and he has an in-house team that does that kind of stuff for him. Now I'm back in my cribbo. I got the picture frames for the other posters that I'm gonna put up in my room, so I'm gonna do that. Oh, don't me and Chance kind of look like twins? Ooh. So I went to the barbershop last night, I got my hair cut, don't I look all purdy? I sat down with the owner for a while. We're gonna try to get the campaign kicked off either this week or next week, because he's going to be gone. He's traveling. I'm about to make some pre-workout. I want to do a bank workout, because I haven't done one in literally probably a month and a half to 2 months. All I do is pull-ups, because I like pulled my rhomboid and shit. And the doctor was like, don't do anything that aggravates the back. Let it rest. So I have, and it still kind of hurts. Like, hurts my neck, like almost like my spine when I do back exercise, whether it's like pulls or whatever. But I've waited too long, I'm too impatient, so I'm gonna try to do it today. I feel like I'm gonna end up paralyzing myself. And I'm gonna mix up some pre-workout, go to the gym. Today's Easter, so I'm gonna be with the fam for the rest of the day. I don't know if I said this before, it's April 16th, Sunday morning, 8:30, 8:15, I don't know. This sucks, like when you wanna make a pre-workout, but you got a full water bottle, so you gotta chug it just to put the thing in there. That's like the perfect amount of water you want left for when you do a pre-workout. Nah, you're gonna get crazy. We're gonna do a third, I have so much pre-workout, a third scoop of Ghost, a third scoop of Muscle Farm, and a third scoop of my pre. So we get all the stimulants in my shit. 5 grams of creatine, and that's it. You know just what we want, I wanna wake up with you in my mind. Life is good right now.
I just finished my workout. Back's actually feeling pretty good. It's like 67 degrees out and it's pretty early. It's like 9:30. I'm actually gonna go to the courts in my town and shoot around a little bit, play some ball. Probably gonna be no one else there though. I didn't go at all this week just because it was spring break in my town, like for my high school. So there was just a billion little kids there the entire week. So I didn't really get to go and shoot around, but I'm gonna go now, mess around a little bit, throw a couple windmills down right quick. Happy Easter, everybody. From the big dog families to y'all's families. Y'all, I say y'all so much, but like it's not like a southern y'all. It's like, what are y'all doing? I feel like that, is that acceptable? Can I say y'all without it being like a Texas thing? I mean, I already do it anyways. Wow, look at this beast. It's like, it's literally in the middle of a mall parking lot and this chick's just riding around in circles on a bike. I'm a big fan of her. I might go ask her out, actually. Fuck it. We're going. I'm just kidding. I should, though. She looked kind of cute. Mad, but, like, why are the basketball gods playing tricks on my mind? It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. Courts are empty. About to run some suicides. We used to have these things in high school when I played basketball in high school. They're called 96ers. You'd run suicides, and you'd have to touch 96 lines. So it'd be like foul line back, half back, three quarters back, full back. I forget what the math behind it is. I think it's 12 suicides at a time. Those are the fucking worst. So we're back at the, let me spin you onto the tripod real quick. Ooh, y'all getting dizzy? All right, so we're back at the cribbo. Play a little ball with Steve. And two things. Let me close my door. One, the proposal that I have to send over to Fantasy Jocks, basically done. All I need to do is kind of hit send on the email. I'm kind of nervous though. You're like, a big email or a big text message to send, you're like about to type it, but you don't want to do it because it's like nerve-wracking as shit. That's where I'm at right now. I'm gonna do it. We'll get it on camera. Plug it. It's on the send button. Boom. Proposal sent. Hopefully we hear some good news back. Also, I've been looking to get into a different editing software for the videos. So I've been using iMovie, which is free. It's like the basic one you get with the Mac, any kind of Mac computer. But I really wanted to get into learning Final Cut Pro because that's like an upgrade and you can do a lot more shit with it. So if any of you guys have like a YouTube channel or whatever you do video-wise and you have an editor that you think is worth the money, please let me know. It's hard to upgrade because like such a steep learning curve, and that's, I'm like 70 videos into my channel. I don't want to learn a whole new software, but I got it. And basically, you get a 30-day free trial, and what you can do is when you open it up, you just change the date on your calendar in your computer. Like, you can push it back, so then, you know, if you're like 15 days into the trial, and it's like, oh, you only have 15 days back, you push the calendar date back like 10 days or whatever, and then it gives you another 25 days. So you can keep doing that rather than paying for the full version. Money's tight right now. Business is strapped. I think I made a huge mistake. So I bought this external hard drive yesterday off Amazon. Because I, like, all the videos I've been shooting and views for YouTube has taken up so much space on this computer that's slowing it down, so I wanted to get them off there, put them onto the hard drive, so this can work a lot faster. And I definitely messed something up, because now the video I was editing for this week just says missing files everywhere, and I don't know what I'm doing. I don't even know if I have the videos anymore. I think I might have deleted them off the camera to make more room. This sucks. This sucks. Tuesday morning, April 18th. Didn't film a single thing yesterday because I'm a fraud. It's 9 a.m. Just got done at the gym. Screaming because the windows are open. Beautiful day. Got a good leg workout in. Did some cardio. So we're heading back to the cribbo now. And I will see you there.
Boom. Woo. Like that little transition right there. Oh, how's my battery almost dead? I lost my other battery for this camera. I think my mom stole it and be making vlogs behind my back. I did a little shopping last night. So I want to show y'all what I picked up. I went to this mall around me that has like a bunch of outlet stores and whatnot. So I went to Saks Fifth Ave. If you have any of these stores like Saks Fifth Ave, Nordstrom Rack, they're basically like the Marshalls for more expensive clothing, but they're all discounted. Got two pairs of bathing suits. We got the crab people. That has crabs on it. That's got anchors on it. So we're ready for summer. It's a company called Trunks. They fit really well, actually. I was pumped up about it, and they were like 18 bucks a piece, as opposed to like $60 at PacSun or some shit. They come with the netting. I don't know what kind of bullshit that's about. I thought they stopped doing that during like the Cisco era, like in via 2002, but apparently not. I'm gonna have to cut those out. And then I went to the Nike outlet store. Some more socks. So I got these shorts. They're like the regular Nike dry fit, but I think they redesigned the the dry fit, I guess, series or whatever you'd call them. And they're fudging amazing. I actually just wore these to the gym. I don't know why I put them in the bag and pretended like I hadn't worn them yet. The other dry fits are like a polyester. They're kind of like the ones where your like fingernails will kind of get caught if you're going up and down with it. These are like a really soft fabric and they're awesome. They're definitely my favorite pair of shorts. I'm probably going to go back and get more of them, to be honest. They were 35 bucks. So they're kind of expensive, but honestly, well worth it. If you're looking for shorts for the summer, they're plain. Nike, they just say dry fit on the side there, and that's really it. And I think they got a Nike symbol somewhere. If you're looking for shorts to play like ball in the summer, just for like the gym, whatnot, these are definitely, definitely worth investing in. What else did we get?
Oh, we got two.
I also got two kind of crew neck sweatshirts. Nike plain black with the white and gray with the white. I don't know why I'm getting on a crew neck run right now. I think that was it. So it's Tuesday, the day after Easter Monday. I don't know if that's a thing. It's a bank holiday, so I'm just waiting on people to get back to me basically via email because most of them weren't in the office yesterday. I sent a proposal over, and the proposal basically consists of what kind of services I can provide along with pricing. So that was the first time doing that, so that should be interesting. I'm gonna put a lot of work in on the blogs right now, specifically for fantasy football. I kind of want to get into this real quick. So when I first got into YouTube with the fantasy football channel, I did it with two of my friends. We put up like the first summer, which was two summers ago. We put up maybe like a total of 5-6 videos, right? For the entire, from the start of summer, probably to like the end of the season. And our subscriber list basically went from 0 to 100 in that time. And it was completely organic. We didn't share anything on Facebook. We didn't share anything on like Instagram. And we posted a little bit on Twitter, just sharing that. So that grew 100% organically by itself from 0 to 100. And I was like completely inconsistent with videos on that. The next year, which was last summer, we probably put up, I was just me by myself, I think at this point mostly. And I put up maybe 12 videos for the entire season from beginning of summer until the end of the football season. Maybe somewhere like 12 to 14, right? And my subscriber list went from 100 to around 500. So like 5X. And then when I started sharing my other stuff and putting my other content on the channel, including whatever it is, you know, like fitness, fashion, style, all that kind of bullshit, and there's vlogs and stuff. I think my list, it's up to like 620 or something like that now. And it's slowly growing, obviously. And those videos I put up, like, are strictly just things that I live, that I like, and those are like my passions and shit. I'm not gonna put up videos that I know nothing about. Like, I'm not gonna go out of my way, do research for 2 hours on what the best tuxedos are, because I don't fucking know what I don't know anything about tuxedos. So these are things that I know about, and these are things that I enjoy talking about, right? But the majority of my growth so far has been strictly from fantasy football. And I'm gonna predict right now, since I have time, I'm gonna be putting up a ton of videos in the off season, and I'm gonna be putting up a ton of videos throughout the season. So right now I have a little over 600 subscribers. I'm gonna predict right now by the end of September, my YouTube channel has between 2,500 and 5,000 subscribers. I know that's a huge growth in the small amount of time, considering that I've grown probably like 150 subscribers in the last like 6 months, but the amount of engagement I get during the fantasy football season is out of control. Like, every video gets up over 1,000. Some of them have hit 20,000. And the mock draft round one video I did, me and my friend Nick did maybe like 2 months ago or something. It only has like 1,200 views right now. It basically owns the top slot when you type in, if you go on YouTube, let me check it out right now. When you type in 2017 fantasy football mock draft, literally number one on YouTube. And that's competing with dudes like the Fantasy Footballers. They're like the biggest podcast in the world right now in terms of fantasy football. So we own that top spot. So I'm predicting that has 1,100 views right now. By the time it hits September, that video will have probably 35 to 40,000 views on it. And that's where my fucking subs start rolling in. And you know, I'm putting in a lot of groundwork right now, the foundation for helping it build. Like, a lot of these videos that I'm putting up now get like 50 to 200 views, right? And you might look at it and be like, why waste your time? And it's because I'm building the foundation for what I think is gonna happen. Those are my predictions right now. I think that video is gonna absolutely blow up, and I think the channel is gonna go through a huge growth spike during the summer when I start consistently putting up those videos. And then from there, you know, that's when I can build on all these other topics and subjects, and when, you know, the way I believe things are right now, your actual business and your personal brand are one and the same, the way like today's world works, right? This kind of growth and this kind of interaction with people is what will help grow my business. Even though Facebook advertising has nothing to do with fantasy football, the reason I like YouTube a lot as compared to, like, you know, I don't even have an Instagram for Big Dogs Gotta Eat, which is probably a mistake. I should do that. But like the interaction level on like Instagram and it's so shallow. Like, you don't really build engagement on there. You need to be like a really hot girl that shows your ass in every picture, and that's the only way you're really gonna be able to make money off those platforms. I think the great thing about YouTube is when people subscribe to your YouTube channel, they're doing it because, you know, you're giving them some kind of value, whether it's information, whether it's entertainment, whether, you know, whatever it might be. And you're kind of like building a relationship with the person, even if you don't know them personally. Over time, you know, you nurture it, you give them so much value, free value, over and over and over and over and over again, that it's almost like a sales funnel. You know, if I have a subscriber that's been subscribed to me for 2 years, and he's watched every one of my videos, he hits me up, he's like, yo, dope video, emails me on the side, and I talk to him a little bit. When I start selling stuff, if I start selling something through YouTube, and YouTube is strictly a marketing platform, the only people that actually make money from YouTube, strictly off views, are people getting like 5 million views per video. It's a ridiculous, you're not making money off YouTube views. I've gotten in the 2 years that I've done YouTube videos, I have probably 60 or 70 videos, I've gotten one check from YouTube, and it was like $115. And keep in mind, my channel's relatively small, but in the lifetime of my channel, I have 88,000 views collectively between all my videos. $100 for 88,000 views, so let that sink in for a sec. My chocolate daddy of YouTube. How much did chocolate daddy sell? 15,000 units. Proud of every single one of them, but you get the point. It's not realistic to make your entire income off YouTube. You make money by using YouTube as a marketing platform for yourself. And then from there, when people build relationships, people value authenticity, people value the connection with you, and you might be selling. So any of you guys right now can set up a t-shirt stand, right? A t-shirt shop. You sell a white t-shirt with a random, your logo on it, but you've never done any marketing, right? You just think it's a cool logo, you're gonna try to sell it. No one's gonna buy your shit. If I did that, say at the end of the summer when I have 2,500 subscribers and I tried selling a t-shirt with my logo on it, I bet you I will be able to sell 10, 20, 30, 40 of those because of the relationship that I've built with subscribers. And this is me, this is my prediction. This is obviously, it's not something I've experienced yet, but I truly feel deep down that's how this whole marketing, that's how this whole sales funnel is gonna work. And that's kind of like the big picture in my head, to be honest with you. That's how I've always thought about it in my head. I've never really got it down on paper or really said it into the channel, but that's how I think these things really, really work. The majority of people I follow a lot of channels on YouTube, a lot of like fitness channels, or kids like my age that basically do like vlogs, and, you know, since the age of like 21, and they're rich as shit now, they built companies. The large majority of them build their YouTube subscription base, so a lot of them are like 200,000, 500,000, a million people, right? But the majority of their business, where they actually monetize, where they make money, has nothing to do with YouTube. That's a marketing platform. They have apparel stores, they have online coaching and for fitness, they have, you know, all these different things that they're kind of dabbling in, sponsorships, those kind of things too. But yeah, that's, I don't know why I just got onto that rant. So I hope that made a little bit of sense. And if it did, scroll down a little bit. Give that video a thumbs up, bro. Come on, bro. No, I'm not stopping the video camera until you scroll down. Like this. And click that thumbs up, bro. Bro, 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 bro. There's like an app on a phone. I think it was called the Bro app. And my one friend had it and he would just like walk around.
Bro, 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 bro.
This is incredible. Kendrick Lamar released the video for DNA. I haven't watched it yet, but the first person that comes on screen, Don Cheadle. Kendrick Lamar, DNA, Don Cheadle. It's the Holy Trinity.
Good morning, beautiful people. Or like the 100 people that watch these videos.
It's Wednesday morning, April 19th, around 9 a.m. And we got good news back on the proposal. We are in it for 3 months. As long as everything goes smoothly, we're going to sign on for another 6 months. That is fantastic. And now I have to work up these legal documents, so like independent contractor document, client agreement document, all these things that need to be legally binding. A lot of legal stuff that I don't really know that much about, but I'm going to have to figure it out. So I'm working on that. And then I'm creating a website right now for the BDGE Media is what I'm going to be calling the Facebook ad business that I'm running. So I'm mocking up a website right now. It's quick, but it's the first draft and looks all right so far. I've only been working on it a couple hours, but I'm eventually going to be practicing what I preach. When I exhaust my immediate network, friends, family, local businesses and stuff, I'm eventually going to be running Facebook ads to try to pull in small businesses via the Facebook ads so that they can be my clients. So I'm going to be eating what I sell. That didn't make sense. I don't think that's how that phrase goes, but you get the point. Now I'm going to hit the gym, I'm going to hit the gym for some HIIT cardio, do some sprints on the treadmill. Suck, but they're my favorite form of cardio. Not my favorite, but it's the best, I believe. And later, I'm in, like, for some reason, ever since I was, like, 10 years old, I don't know how my name got on this list, but I do these focus groups, right? Like, these focus groups for, like, products or services. You've probably, like, heard about these things that they get research from random people, potential customers, for before, like, a product launches or, like, a movie launches or anything like that, and you go to this research center, and they pay you, they're paying me $250 for 4.5 hours today, so I'm like, sick. So that's gonna be the rest of my day, kind of working on those things. And so I'm on my way to this focus group thing, and my GPS says I'm gonna get there at 12:30. Like, I'm gonna arrive at the building at 12:30. And they told me, you have to be there 15 minutes early. If you're late, they're not gonna let you in. So I'm like 100% about to drive. An hour and 10 minutes, oh shit. An hour and 10 minutes, and then they're just gonna be like, nah, son. No. They let your boy in. I drove like 169 miles an hour. Cut off like 10 minutes from my time that I was supposed to get there. And honestly, basically, shut the fuck up. And basically, the study group was like, they put 15 of us in a room. It was in a lawyer's office. And we had to talk about, they showed us two videos and we had to talk about these cases. And basically, I guess the lawyers just wanted to get feedback on, like, what kind of different thoughts people had, like, what kind of point of views, a jury would take that's made up of random people. And it's some of the things that people, like, the things people say are outrageous, like, literally outrageous in that room. Like, you get a room full of 12 random people, and that's going to be the jury on, like, a murder case. It's going to decide someone's life. Some of them are so dumb. It makes no sense. I'm like, yo, they're really going to decide, like, if someone killed someone else because this asshole, like, couldn't pass the fourth grade and now he's randomly selected. Dude, I don't know. Gym went on a little grocery run. Oh, yeah, I'll take 2 trips. I'm the hero. Oh, shit. So I'll do what we got right quick. Some tendies, some frozen berries to thicken any shakes you make. Some taters. Usually eat those breakfast with eggs or something. Spinach for my Hulk juice. Band-Aids for my broken heart. Beef jerky, because protein. Because zero calories for 1/4 spray. So you just go zero, 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 zero. It works. Cold cuts. Someone on one of my videos a while ago commented that ham is the Kirk Cousins of cold cuts. I don't know how to take that. Kirk Cousins has a great year, so fuck you. If you're trying to diss Kirk Cousins or ham, get off my channel. And I got an entire bag of these Dan and Greek yogurts. They're like 80 calories, 12 grams of protons. Caramel apple pie is the goat flavor. So I got an entire bag of those. Some almond milk. This is the only milk that I drink. Almond milk, unsweetened vanilla. I don't understand how it's unsweetened and vanilla, but whatever, it works. I drink this like at night. I feel like an old man. I'm like 95 years old. Like, oh, I need my glass of milk. What else do we get? Natters. Some opals. Opals and bononos. What a ridiculous song. Why did they teach us that? I guess that works for the vowels, right? Eeples and beninis. Now it's fucking vodka and bellinis. And then I got some Powerade Zero, some water. So that's the grocery haul for this week, I guess, for however long it lasts me. I think that's actually gonna conclude this week's video. So let's recap real quick. We're drafting up contracts for Fantasy Jocks. And I'm gonna be honest with you, I don't think I can legally talk about it anymore. Well, at least not the in-depth part of the deal. That was a big win for Big Dog Gotta Eat. First real paying client that I'm working with contractually, legally, all that good stuff. So that's one on the board. Like I said, I'm taking this business slow. I'm learning as I go. And that's really it. So I hope you enjoyed the video. I'm gonna keep putting these styles of video up. And I'm keeping most of them around 25 minutes. I think that's a good length for like, it's almost like an episode of a TV show. Not that I'm entertaining enough to have my own TV show like that. But I'm appreciative for all you guys that do watch these. Thank you for the support. Go give it a thumbs up if you like the video. And realistically, I'm not doing these videos for entertainment purposes for you guys right now, but I'm doing it to document everything, and then in a few years when I look back, hopefully, you know, you or I, anyone out there, can use this as like a learning experience kind of thing. If you're trying to start your own thing, you need maybe motivation, you need direction, you can look back at this and be like, wow, this kid was a loser, don't do what he did, go a different direction. Or you can be like, wow, it's 2020 and this kid is really successful. I wonder how he did it. I'm gonna be like, go look at my YouTube channel. I literally documented everything I did. So that's it. It's either gonna be really good or really bad. But I have a good feeling about this. So sorry, I just keep literally walking from room to room. That's what I do. I pace around when I get, not nervous, but I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do with my hands. All right, well, that's it. I'll see you guys next week, AKA tomorrow.